are carriers of what was already done in heaven. Amen. And as we pull from heaven, we understand what Jesus has done for us at the cross. We receive our right. We receive our position in the Lord. What we do now is we carry that, and our words now have authority and power because we just take from heaven and apply it here on earth.
And we carry a culture that's willing to stop, to see, to speak, to love, to give, to be inconvenienced, to pay a price, knowing that the price that we pay, you want the cross culture? Jesus paid a price, Paul paid a price, Peter paid a price, they all paid a price. You think we get to a place where the grace of God says you don't pay a price? No, no, you don't understand. It's the grace of God that gives you the ability to pay whatever price needs to be paid.
It is finished!
The Lord is very personal, and He loves to be personal with you. Do you know it? The Lord came down so much time ago, but today, in His life, He looks you now right in the eyes and He says, I'm your Savior and I love it. I came down for you. It was for you.
We are here in this place where Jesus is showing His face and moving and releasing things from heaven into the earth today.
My friends, no matter how fractured your family is, no matter how dead those bones may seem, no matter how broken a friendship may be, no matter how divided a church or a movement or a nation, a government may seem, it is no match for the prophetic power of God, the power of the cross, and the spoken word of His people saying bones come to life. Because the scripture says to me that no matter how many promises God has made, they are all yes in Christ. And it is our job to say yes and amen. We speak what He speaks, and we call on the Spirit of God to breathe on fractured families, to effect the power of the cross and make it known in our day. The atmosphere is changing now,
for the Spirit of the Lord is. The scriptures say of itself that all scripture is God breathed. So when the kiss of God comes, it's a spirit kiss, it's not a physical kiss. But when He kisses you, He breathes in the scriptures. It's one thing to study the Bible, it's another thing for the Bible to study you. Jesus was the Word made flesh, but we are the flesh, we made the Word. And when the living Word kisses you, He breathes in the power that was breathed into the scripture. His kiss is a word kiss. And when He speaks and kisses you with that word, you become that word. You don't have to try to become it. When He says something to you, you become that.